And now we will learn how to record basic deposits. Believe it or not, this is not the recommended way to input them. When would we record a basic deposit? Well, when the payment we receive for a service goes immediately into the bank account. We would also use the window I'm about to show you only when we do not need to track the quantity. For example, if we give a service and we need to know how many hours we sacrificed to get that money, we should not record it in the deposit window because there is no field for quantity. Also, when you record a deposit from a customer, you will not see them in the customer center or on the customer reports. So if you don't need to see the results in the customer center and you don't need to see the results of the deposit on the customer related reports, then you can record it in the way that I'm about to show you. For example, let's imagine on February 20, we received $2,000 from Candy for an editing service, and it was directly deposited into the Chase bank account, confirmation number 09876. Now let's think about what the results in the trial balance will be before we record this deposit. Well, cash in Chase Bank now, if we click reports and we click my trial balance, we can see that before we record this, cash in Chase Bank is $14,770. So what will it be after we record this $2,000? The Chase Bank becomes $16,770. That's the number to expect after we record this. What will editing income become? Well, right now, editing income is, $15,960? So it would make sense that it would become $17,960 after we record this $2,000 editing income job for Candy, or that was done for Candy. Now to make the deposit, it's very simple. Click the plus sign and all the way to the right on the top, click bank deposit. Now this is your basic deposit window. The date of the deposit was February 20. Now, leave the bank account that you're depositing the money into and notice it's showing you the balance. Where it says received from, click directly under there and choose the customer you received it from. Let me double check that that was, that was Candy. Excuse me, so we want to make sure. See, it's warning you that you shouldn't do it the right way, and we're going to talk about what this warning means in a future video. But really, we said that the customer is Candy. Now, the account is the income that was earned. And in this case, the income that was earned is editing income. And then you just put the amount. In this case, the amount was $2,000. Push tab. Notice there is no field to record the quantity. So instead of save and new, I like to click save and close if I'm finished. Now when we look at the results, cash in Chase Bank, $16,770. That's exactly what we expected. And editing income, $17,960. And guess what? That's exactly what we expected. Now let's record a second example, and then I'll show you the right way to do it. Let's imagine on February 21, we received $3,000 from Alan for a video service, and that money was directly deposited into the Chase bank account, and here's the confirmation number. What will the results be in the trial balance? Well, cash in bank becomes $3,000 more than this number, so therefore cash in bank becomes $19,770. Video income increases by $3,000, so video income will be $3,000 more than this number, which means video income will become $34,800. Let's go ahead and record it, and this time I won't forget to put in the confirmation number. On the top right by the plus sign, we click, and then we go down to click Bank Deposit. Now we know the date was February 21. And we know we received the money from Alan Arby. We know the account, see, it's just warning us about something we're going to learn in a future video. Now the account is video income because that's the income we earned. The reference number is really the confirmation number that I forgot to put last time, 543210. So we'll make sure we put it in this time, 543210. Now, the amount is 3,000. So now we have all the information we need, or at least we have all the information that we think we need, and it's everything we're going to get from this basic deposit window. After I click Save and Close, I can see my trial balance numbers are exactly what we predicted. Cash and Chase Bank, $19,770, and video income, $34,800. Now let me show you why this is not the best way to record this type of circumstance. Number one, if I click Sales, and I go to the Customer Center, and I click All Sales, notice neither of the two deposits that we just made are showing up in the sales list in the Customer Center. In fact, even if we click Customers and we click on the specific customer here in the Customer Center, in this case Alan, we would get every transaction that we ever made with Alan except for the deposits. So if you make that transaction in the window that I just showed, it will not show up here. You should also know when I click Reports and I go to All Reports and I click Sales by Customer Detail for the sales related reports, of course I'm going to go all dates. You can see by this report that we learned about before will show every invoice and every sale receipt that you recorded in the invoice window and the sale receipt window, but it is not showing any of the deposits that we just made, even though those two deposits that we just made were actually sales of a service. So, what would be a better way to record these two transactions? Well, we already learned about sales receipts. We already learned that we can record sales receipts directly into the bank account. That's the way that we did it. We learned that sales receipts give us the ability to track the quantity of the hours given. We were not able to put that in the deposit window. And sales receipts will show in the Customer Center, deposits will not. Sales receipts will also actually show up on the Sales by Customer Detail report, and deposits will